Hello all, and welcome back to the next installment in Let's Play Golden Sun. I grinded, I am now level 7 on all my characters that I currently have. But yeah, you can see the overlay changed, as promised. This time, it's Ivan, or in our case, Sammy. Why not? Wow, I was lucky to not get an encounter there. I'm glad I do have the grinding off screen, because it just makes it easier. Off screen I can use the fast forward function and just, you know, go to town. It makes life a little bit easier. And now we get another cutscene. Which I find out I can't move that. No, my synergy is not strong enough to move that stump. However, Sammy's is. It's early. There we go. Bye-bye, Ivy. Sorry, this music is my favorite soundtrack. Yay! Now, I think, if you remember that Merc wand I bought in episode 3? Well, here's where it gets its use. And now he has a stronger attack. That's all that it's used for, so that way he gets better attack. I don't know if you guys have noticed yet, but there's something called Unleash, which is what happens when you attack with an artifact. It gets a special ability, and that ability will allow you to do major damage to an enemy by an attack. So, the Merc Wand, I believe, puts people to sleep, if I remember correctly. There's Rapid Smash. That's the Pirate Swords. There's Merc, see, it puts the other head to sleep, now they can't attack. Now, sometimes it will unleash Merc and won't put them to sleep. Sometimes it will. It's actually random. So, I'm trying to remember what to do here. It's been a while since I've been in this cave. I played the last stage. I've been playing it on my own casually again, and I've been comparing how smooth it actually is, and it is a lot smoother. It's already go this way. Oh, nope, they're more than 3. That should take care of them all. Emphasis on should. Cool. Nope, I went down. My gosh! I don't need to heal anyone yet. That'll come later. I forget if there's a djinn in this cave, there might be. Might be a Jupiter Gen. Which would be great for Ivan. Or Sammy. Cool. I did do that right. I obviously cannot forget about this chest here. It's part of 100%. Get every item. Well, get every item possible, should I say. The reason I say that is, in the second game, there's an item that you cannot get until, like, very much later, so it'll look like I'm missing a chest, but I'm actually not. There are a lot of items that are, based upon what synergies you have, and things like that. So, I have to keep my eye out for all of them. It's not 100% if I don't get everything, is it? I really don't like groups of enemies, because, you know, they're easy to deal with synergy, but as you can see, my synergy is limited. And Sony just leveled up, pretty sure that was Sammy. Yeah, he's only level 5. Yep, there's a Jin. Gotta go and get that thing. You guys, if you'd like to, let me know in the comments if you want me to speed up battle scenes, because I will. They take forever, they are kind of annoying, but it's part of the drama of the game. If you'd like me to speed them up, let me know. If not, I'll just keep them the way they are, and we'll just go along with whatever happens. It's gonna be nice when I have his Rapid Smash. He tends to unleash it more often, and a lot more happens with it. Dang. I always hope he'll put it to sleep. Because if he does, then the enemy can't attack. Even if I don't kill him, the enemy can't attack. And he can't do anything. It's great. It's funny, because in my Lost Age playthrough currently, I have 3 weapons, and every single one of them can put an enemy to sleep. And it's just great, because basically all my characters has an attack that has the chance to put an enemy to sleep. It's like, oh wait, you're not asleep? Okay, let's try again. And it's just, it's so funny, because it just can't do anything, and it's amazing. Anyway. I jump over there? Didn't think about that before. I might be able to jump over there. Yes, I can. Cool. I only have a single gem. Well, I don't think this gem has very much health. Awesome, now can't even escape. Sometimes gems can flee, then you just have to go back and fight them again, and it's really annoying. That is our second Jin out of the 28 that we get in total. Yep, that's right, we get 28 Jin in total. 7 for each character, and there are 4 characters. And now we can go in and out of Goma Cave, and it's gonna be my next training grounds. I forget if they give me a synergy stone or not. Sometimes caves will give you one at the very end. Sometimes they don't. This one did not. And normally, I'd go straight to this town. Billabin. Which I will go in, but not for the reason that you think. So in order to start the next quest line, we have to have a very specific point done, but there is something else here that I need instead. And that is our first Jupiter Djinn, because Sammy needs to become more powerful. That's all that we're gonna get in this town. Maybe get, well, check for weapon and armor upgrades, because it's always good to have those. And then we're just gonna head on to the next quest point, which will be a basically a giant forest. And I think we can also get another djinn. I'm gonna try to at least. If I can get another djinn before the forest, it's gonna make all of this a million times easier. The enemies in the forest are really strong, and I need to train up before then. So, after this episode, when I come back, I'll be probably closer to level 10 on everyone. It'll make going through the forest a lot easier. Any encounters won't take very long to take care of, that sort of thing. Okay, so there is no artifact armor yet. I do not want a game ticket. They are basically useless. Probably check for artifacts first. Awesome. I don't want a game ticket. I'll check for artifacts. Yeah, I thought so. But they don't have any yet. All the armor upgrades. I'm gonna make sure everybody is all set up for the next area. No, I don't need it. I could probably take the tickets and just sell them, but it's really not worth it. Yes, I do want to have that. Sorry, Sammy. We keep getting their names mixed up. I apologize for that. No one. Nope. I do not want the game tickets. I wish it would just stop. Wow. I'm not gonna get the wooden cap. It's only one. Literally one extra defense, which is pretty much meaningless. And we'll take a rest at the end, recover our synergy, and get going. There is a cutscene here. It basically is just people telling us, hey, don't go to the forest. You're gonna get turned into a tree. Like the tree at the very front of the village. But we're gonna ignore all of that. So, and honestly, you don't need to do anything to continue. And there's other dialogue that we can get when we get back after we finish everything. So I want you guys to see that dialogue. It's a more of a secret dialogue that most people don't know about. See, normally to get through this, you have to talk to the person, he'll say he'll give you a key, then he doesn't give you the key. And it just turns out that you don't need one anyway. Those three trees will become very important later on. And now for a Borderlands reference. Welcome to the forest of being eaten alive by trees. You'll know what I mean, just a sec. Gonna take care of these annoying enemies. Probably didn't need very well. Forest of being eaten alive by trees. And here's a cutscene. Now that town that you saw, we're gonna be going there next. There's a Venus Djinn there that I believe we can get now. If not, we'll have to go back and get it later. But So now we get to meet Trett, who's currently trying to turn us into a tree. Look, bubbles. They're protecting us. Whoa. Can anybody take a guess as to what it is? I'll give you one guess, and it's the prominent feature of this game. I meant to say yes. I pressed B by accident. Yep. If you guess energy, you were right. It's energy that we get that we don't get to use all the time. Yep, that was the thought. Yes, it does. Also, let me know if I'm going through these text boxes a bit quickly. I'm a very quick reader, so if I need to, I'll slow down for you guys. Yeah. Oh, look, we're trying to turn us into trees again. There's Trett. I forget her name. I think it's Serena, but I don't remember. So Trett and this girl, I'm just gonna call her Selena until I figure out what her real name is. They're two giant trees in the forest. Yeah, I'll get to you in just a moment. Yep. I have an idea. So it's almost quite literally the forest of being eaten alive by trees. Okay, now to Kolima. So everybody here is a tree. And there's Venus in there. I believe I can get it. I forget if I actually can or not until later on, but I think I can get it early. Cool, it's stunned. Almost basically as good as being put to sleep. Come on. I feel like dealing with you guys right now, so I do this spare time. So, one thing about Golden Sun is it's very puzzle-oriented. So, every dungeon, everywhere you go, there's some form of puzzle that you have to complete. Cool. This will make life easier inside the tree. Ding! So, Granite is very good, because he can increase your defense inside. The best djinn in the game, in my opinion, is Flash. Now, Flash does, it basically makes, so an enemy that would normally do 20 damage would do like 1 damage, for example. Flash is a very, very powerful djinn. But we don't get him until later on. But once you do, it's like, oh, you're trying to attack me? Well, I've got some bad news for you. It's not gonna work. We got our Jhin. Now we can go to the forest. What I think I'll do is I'll do the puzzles and end once we're inside of Tret, and then take care of Tret when I get back, because otherwise I won't have time to grind, and I need to grind before Tret. Sure, I don't have to, because I'm an experienced player, and the thing about experienced players is some of them can just take care of bosses at the earliest level, because we just know what to do. But for the sake of safety, I'm not going to do that. Even though it's very easy to do. Like, he's not a very hard boss to beat. Oh boy. Puzzle time. Maybe I'll gain all the levels I need to before. That'd be fun. I gotta look out for nuts, because there's a tree here that does have nuts, so... wrong way. Gotta go up. Yes, keep giving me these drone bees. They're perfect. Also, Ivan, keep doing that stun voltage. It's great. Sammy, not Ivan. I need somebody to start correcting me on that. Just yelling at me every time I get their names wrong. Well, the custom names wrong. Might be able to just kill the skeleton. I got lucky with that rapid smash, honestly. So I don't know if you noticed, but like, I will try and avoid using synergy wherever possible, because it takes a bit to recharge. Like I said, you can recharge by walking around, as I said earlier, but it just takes a while. You can sleep at an inn to restore it. There are other things you can do. So I try and avoid using it wherever possible. For large groups of enemies like this, I obviously will use it for the sake of it's just a pain in the butt to kill them all. Really? That head didn't die? That is actually surprising. Well, regardless, it is dead now. Next. I did that for Bash, so I only needed to attack him with two people. Oh well. Oh, even without Rapid Smash. Sweet. That's good to know. Okay, time for some fun. Well, nope, not yet. This is not the fun puzzle yet. That comes later. I will be getting a new overlay image soon, so expect that. It's going to replace the Golden Sun GBA box art, mostly because Ivan is just such a big character, and some of the other characters have to resize and such to make them all fit. So I'm going to be getting a new overlay on the side, so expect that. For the time being, it's just going to stand me for a while. I'm going to have to start hitting myself if I don't get that right. Now comes the fun puzzle. Because there's an item here. So you actually have to do this two times. One to get to the item, and another one to go to the next area. Well, actually, I'm going to do something else to make this even easier that I didn't think about doing beforehand. I'm going to make it go to the next area, because I can push that tree stump out of the way, and then deal with it. That way I have just an easy path, and I will take care of the puzzle to go get the item next. And after this, we'll be right about at the point where we can crawl inside of the tree. So that is my hope, that we get to that point. And there we go. Now we have an easy path, and after we finish this other puzzle to get this item, we can just not worry about redoing it. Let's see if I remember the right combination. Luckily, enemies will not attack me here. If the puzzle is large enough, one thing I've noticed about Golden Sun is sometimes the enemies will not attack. Okay, so... I can't do that. I have to do... Dang, I messed it up already. Well, shoot. I can't leave the area because things will happen if I do. Figured it out. I think. No, that doesn't do it either. Dang, what is this puzzle? There we go. Now I got it. There we go. That's better. Now we can go get that item, which is actually a really good item for defense and such. It's one of the very first, actually I think it is the first artifact that we get in terms of equipment. Not weapons, just, you know, defense equipment, that sort of thing. I may have played this recently, but that does not mean that I remember the puzzles. I actually probably shouldn't have bought that leather armor since I knew this was coming up, but to be honest, I forgot about it, so, oh well. Okay. So here we are. Let's see what her name is. It's never too late. Now, monsters do spawn here, so I was actually a bit surprised by that, because I completely forgot that they did. No, I did not mean to attack that one. Dang it. Next. Okay, so this is where I'm leaving it. Level 8, and level 6. So, thanks for watching. Please like, comment, and subscribe. And next week, we'll get episodes 5 and 6. Also, join us on Discord. I am starting a new thing, where if you're in the Discord server, you will be able to see all videos 1 week early. I will post them as unlisted, since I'm pre-recording them. And, yeah. Everybody will get to see the videos 1 week early, and it'll be cool. But only if you're in the Discord server, otherwise you don't get the unlisted link. Sorry, that's just how it is. So, join the Discord server, and I will see you guys next week. Have a good weekend, everyone.